But there's some level at which you're impaired, and impairment is impairment, and you shouldn't be behind the wheel.
Right, right. We found that even at the minimal, the lowest possible blood alcohol level of 0.01, you're 46% more likely to be blamed for a crash than is the sober person you crash into. So if I have the 0.01% in me and you're sober and we crash, I'm 46% more likely to be blamed than you are. And that's based on hundreds of thousands of cases, yeah.
Can you give us a sense of what 0.01 is in terms of how much alcohol you've had?
One or two cans of beer.
There are a lot of people who drive having one or two cans of beer.
Yeah, yeah, right.
And they would absolutely put their hand up and say, I'm safe.
Right.
Maybe, I don't know what your data set says,
right,
doctor,
right.
But I'm safe.
I once heard a California Highway Patrolman give the following evidence that would appeal to people who would say that they're safe. He says he invites people over to his house to play darts, and he gives half of them beer and the other half not beer. Then he looks at the scores of the people with the beer and the people without the beer. In my case, I had learned this because I had a neighbor across the street who used to play pool with him, and I was somewhat better than he was, slightly better pool player. And then he started saying, Dave, wouldn't you like a half glass of beer? And then when I had a half glass of beer, I was consistently worse than him. So that'll do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I mean, something as small as that.
Right.
Obviously, a question is going to come up somewhere along the line is, if I've had something to drink, how long do I need to wait before I can drive? And how do I know what my blood alcohol level is, whether I've gotten down to a level where it's okay? If I had a drink at 5 o'clock and it's 9 o'clock, can I drive?
Yeah. Well, the California Highway Patrol website has a chart which gives information on this, but they unfortunately combine they have the range 0.01 to 0.04 all in one clump, so you can't see what's going on in tiny increments. But what we can see is that no matter how you parse it, people with 0.01% are significantly much more often blamed for the crash than people who are sober. And in an earlier paper we did in addiction, we showed that not only are these minimally buzzed people more likely to be blamed for the crash, but they cause more dangerous crashes. More people are killed in that kind of crash.